yeah. Brassy girls everywhere, titty ass hands in the air. So party over here, shaking for the man of the year. Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to be doing a comparison video between the Dragon Red Maritime and the FMA Maritime. So one big thing that you're probably going to notice right off the bat is the color is very different. The color on the FMA Maritime is close to the real thing, and this is just stock. We didn't customize it at all. It's just the same stock paint. So with the Dragon Red Maritime that we have here, we did a custom paint job to it not too long ago, and we tried to get a pretty similar look to the FMA's representation of the Opscore's urban tan color, and we really didn't do that great of a job, but it's a lot better than the original color, which was like a different kind of puke kind of looking brown. Moving on, the rails are slightly different. The FMA rails are slightly wider, and they are closer to the scale of the actual Opscore Maritime. You can see it has a little bit more width on this side, or a little more girth, and up here up top, while the Dragon Red is a little bit thinner and skinnier here and along the side right there. But overall, this one, it represents a closer replica to the regular Opscore Maritime rails. Okay, so here we have the FMA Maritime, and so some things that we added to it is we added some FMA Peltor arc rail adapters for your Comtech 2s and 3s. We also added an FMA L4 G24. One problem that we had, like a tiny little problem to put it in, kind of had to shave down the bash shroud just a bit. Moving on, we also have a Mantis strobe right here, a replica Mantis strobe. Okay, so now we're going to go into some of the things that the FMA Maritime comes in, like with the package, and some additions that it has. One thing I forgot to mention is that the bash shroud is plastic compared to the metal Dragon Red bash shroud. But moving on inside, the pads are a little bit stiffer than the Dragon Red pads. The Dragon Red ones were made out of like a memory foam sort of material. This one is just kind of like a sort of like a memory foam, but not as soft, if you know what I mean. And so the moving on to the shell, it's a little bit thinner. This is maybe about like a quarter of an inch thick, but it does not mean that it's weak in any way. It doesn't give way to any pressure if you put it on the sides. It's still very durable, and while keeping it very lightweight at the same time. Now, one thing that we did notice is that the FMA Maritime is a little bit bigger compared to the Dragon Red Maritime. This one is the large, extra large version, while the Dragon Red that we're gonna show you in a little bit is a medium large version. So there's just like a small little difference. But just be mindful that if you're gonna be ordering the FMA Maritime, that you're most likely gonna want to get the large version rather than the small version, unless you have like a smaller head. So here, what I have with me is the Dragon Red Maritime, and now we've already been over the Dragon Red Maritime, and there will be a link in the description to our past video that we did on this and like what it comes in the package and all that stuff. But some additions that I made to this is I put some Z Tactical Peltor arc rail adapters on here attached to my Comtech 2s. Now, sadly, unlike the FMA ones, these do not rotate or swivel. That's one kind of downside that I had. And I also put my Contour on the side here, mounted it via Velcro, and I have the little lanyard attached to some of the little loops that are inside the arc rail. So what I have on right now is the Dragon Red Maritime. Now I'm going to give you a little 360 so you can see how it looks, and we're going to switch over to the FMA after.
Yeah. Finally, the illest crip, and I guarantee I spit harder than concrete. Surprise, I got teeth. My lungs in hell keep AOT with TAC.
So that is the conclusion to our FMA Dragon Red Marathon comparison video. Really hope you enjoyed it. Now, like I said before, the video for the Dragon Red, like, whole first look at it is going to be in the description, the link to that video. And also, be sure to like us on Facebook. And not many people know, we do have an Instagram page. We post on there almost daily. So if you can give us a follow and check out our photos, that'd be great. So stay tuned for another episode, and thanks for watching.